All right, so I wanted to show in a video really quick what's in my gallery. And I'm already being harassed. I'm being gang stalked, and they're harassing me with their headlights. They do this every time I leave the house. This is how they're forcing their victims to isolate, and isolation is a key component to the psychological operation. The psyops feel a lot greater when the victim is in isolation. But you can see here what all is in my gallery. There's not very much at all. And what is in here is all pertaining to the show, to the program, and to this psychological operation, this gang stalking hyper-simulation that I've been forced into since COVID-19 has began. So the reason why I wanted to go ahead and show you the gallery is because if you look here, missing videos, some videos in your project could not be found. Would you like to search for the missing videos? I'm going to go ahead and say no, because I just deleted these ones. And so technically it should be saying this about the photos that are clipped to this video here. So I'm going to delete that, and you can see how I just went ahead and deleted that, and that's just the voiceover portion of it that I deleted. And then the remaining portion of it that you can see is deleted from my gallery. It's still in this video when it should be saying the same thing that you've seen that it just said when I clicked it back on. And it said that about the two other videos that I deleted. But it's not saying that about these here. So something wants me to continue this program. Okay. And so despite all of the people telling me, please stop, and I understand your concern, I honestly feel compelled by the Holy Spirit to do what I'm doing. And I cannot stop. And I will not stop. If I've gone to jail, that proves I'm not going to stop. Jail doesn't scare me. If I've gotten chemically and physically restrained, put into restraints, that straitjacket thing, and then tranquilized, obviously that's not enough to scare me and into, you know, silencing me. Like I said, when I was a child, I was taught to kick, scream, and fight and be as loud as you possibly can when somebody is exploiting you. I'm currently being extorted for a profit, and that's exactly what this show is, a version of that to me. So that's my version of kicking and screaming and fighting like hell, even if it means to the death. So I just wanted you guys to see that all of this information right here, you're not going to find this information anywhere. You can look for years. Many people will live hundreds and thousands of lifetimes and never know about gang stalking. So I don't do this for money, and honestly, the restitution aspect of it, I'm sure that I'm going to look back in the future sometime and think to myself, like, you know, how ridiculous this whole thing was. I don't want to be rich and famous, okay? I don't want your fucking money. I don't want your fame. I don't want your empathy. I don't want your attention. I don't want your time. I want to make that very apparent. You have absolutely nothing that I want or need. I have done this with nothing more than the Holy Spirit within me. And that's it. So, you know, I take back all the things that I, all the times that I said I want restitutions. I'm aware that Jerron's family and my family are owed restitutions. I'm fully aware. But I don't want your nice brand new car. I don't want your nice brand new house. I don't want your hair. I don't want your glasses. I don't want your job. I don't want your obesity and your struggles with that. Okay, you have nothing that I want. You have nothing that I need. Quite the contrary.